Okay, another weekend. We're beginning this ride at Independence Grove again, so I'm down another $12, but I wanted to start here for this ride because I looked on the map and it does look like the best place to get the ride that we're going to do in. Last week's ride, we were headed north all the way up to Russell Road. Now we're headed south all the way into Cook County. Okay, so this is where we went last week. North on the Des Plaines River Trail. This week we're going to be heading south, which is right here. You don't even have to cross the bridge crossing the river here. We just start heading south from here. So when you're heading south on the Des Plaines River Trail, it exits Lake County at Lake Cook Road. And that road is basically the dividing line between Lake County and Cook County. So then the trail continues south from there. I believe it's broken up in a couple of spots. That's gonna be a separate ride. Once we get down to Lake Cook Road, I'll decide if I wanna venture on further. I might go all the way down to this Winkleman Road, which is where the trail technically stops. And you have to pick it up a little further down the line to pick it up and head south again. About 1.3 miles in, we come across a bike repair station with a bike pump and some standard tools. So that's pretty nice. As I mentioned before, last week I rode the Des Plaines River Trail headed north all the way up to Russell Road. If you haven't seen that video, click the info tag above. It's a really nice ride. If you're in the Lake County area, the whole Des Plaines River Trail, which cuts through almost the entirety of Lake County, is one of the finest trails in Lake County. And I've been on most of them at this point. Also, while I do bitch about the $12 for parking, I did learn that if you are a Lake County resident, you don't have to pay anything for parking, but you have to prove residency. So there's also a way for you to get a sticker if you live in Lake County, so they don't bother having to ask for your ID. You can just point to the sticker and they'll wave you through. But on the weekends, if you're not a Lake County resident, it's $12 to park. And the rest of the week, Monday through Friday, I believe, is $6. Just past the Route 176 underpass, you're gonna be able to have access to the North Shore bike path if you turn left and go up this way. So if you were to turn left here, basically you can make your way all the way to Lake Michigan. You can make it all the way to the Robert McClory Trail and then go on right on Stockton Avenue, basically until it dead ends at Lake Michigan. So that's definitely something that's cool to do. So if you turn at that North Shore bike path, and instead of going east to Lake Michigan, if you decide to go west, there is a way where you can make your way back onto the Millennium Trail, and you can make yourself all the way back to Lakewood Forest Preserve in Wakanda. So a lot of the Lake County trails, the big ones, are interconnected to other trails, which makes for a large variety of riding. And that's one of the reasons I don't mind paying the $12, because I don't pay any Lake County taxes. Okay, so right around 4.9 miles into the ride, you're gonna run across Old School Forest Preserve just past St. Mary's Road. Now this is another place where you could park. I don't see a restroom here, but there are restrooms elsewhere in this forest preserve. But if you were not interested, if you're on a weekend and you're not a Lake County resident and you're interested in not paying the $12 at Independence Grove, you definitely could drive the 5 miles south, basically, to St. Mary's Road and park at Old School Forest Preserve, pick up the trail here, and then do the parts that you want to do. So like 0.2 miles further up, there's a much larger parking lot here. I still see no restrooms here. We'll be right back. So roughly 8.5 miles in, we have another trail access. There's parking here. Looks like they also have the picnic table. I don't see any bathrooms or anything. In fact, I don't even see a garbage can, and I actually need one right now. Okay, so roughly about 10 and a half miles into the ride, we come across the Half Day Forest Preserve. As you saw, there's it's not well signed, but I was able to pull off the trail to the right and cut right through the grass here. And then restrooms are over here. Garbage cans, picnic tables, that kind of stuff. So it looks like the shelter here gets rented. There's something going on here right now with a bunch of people. So I'm gonna cut right back through. Okay, I'm at mile marker 31.4, which is on the bridge right over Lake Cook Road. So this is the south end of the Lake County section of the Des Plaines River Trail. This bridge is in two sections. So if you're interested in seeing what it looks like a little further into Cook County, go ahead and click that info link above. Otherwise, I'm going to be heading back about 16 miles back to the car at Independence Grove in Libertyville. Right now, we're currently in Wheeling, right above Lake Cook Road. So I'm back at that old school forest preserve. There is in fact a restroom here. It's not immediately apparent by the parking lot, but if you go down the path that you just saw, it's just right around the corner. So that's useful.